Hello, everyone, and thank you for taking the time to join us. In today's digital world, nearly every application we interact with requires a personal account and profile. From an e-commerce platform storing our delivery address to a workforce portal containing our professional details, it's frequently necessary to access or modify users' personal details. My name is Linda Park.
And my name is Yoel Horowitz. We are product managers with the MicroIdNE product group. And in this video, we'll discuss options available for you to access and update users' profile in Microsoft Entra External ID.
Initially, when a user is created, only a few details are added to their profile. A user's profile can be managed by themselves or by a customer service representative. Let's start with the admin experience. Admins can edit user profiles using the user administrator role. They must sign in with MFA. In the Microsoft Entra Admin Center, navigate to Identity, Users, then select All Users. Search for and select a user. Select Edit Properties to edit the profile. For example, under Contact Information, you could change the city to Tokyo and the country to Japan. And finally, select Save. Take a note of the user object ID that gets created, which is a unique identifier of the user. This one starts with 60F6. Whenever an admin or a representative makes updates, the audit logs will record the changes. From the menu, select Monitoring and Health, and then select Audit Logs. Filter the category by User Management. Then select a record. And it will show information about the activity, like the actor, who is the individual that made the changes. You can see their object ID and their user principal name, among other information. The Targets tab reveals the affected user. It's the same user with the object ID that started with 60F6. Finally, the Modified Properties tab shows old and new values of changed attributes. Self-service account management is a pivotal aspect of modern user support, providing users with the autonomy to handle their own account information without the need for direct interaction with customer service representatives. This approach not only empowers customers by giving them immediate control over their accounts, but it also streamlines operations for businesses, reducing the workload on customer support teams and lowering operational costs. To enable self-service account management, your application defines the user interface to render and collect the data, or run input validation defined by your organization. An example of validation could be something like, check the entered city against the list of allowed cities. To retrieve and update a user's data, the application invokes Microsoft Graph Me endpoint. The Microsoft Graph Me endpoint allows users to manage their own account information in a secure and efficient manner on behalf of the signed-in user. The term on behalf of the signed-in user refers to actions taken by an application that are performed under the authority and identity of a user who is currently signed into the system. When an application operates on behalf of a signed-in user, the audit logs will record the actor, which is a signed-in user who initiated the changes, and that the very same user is the one who has been affected. For better security posture, we recommend you configure multi-factor authentication so that the user is prompted with a challenge before accessing their profile data. This extra layer of security ensures that only you can make the changes to your profile, protecting your profile from unauthorized access and potential compromises. Let me now hand it over to Yoel, who will demonstrate the self-service account management experience.
Thank you, Linda. I will be demonstrating the self-service account management experience through Woodgrove Groceries Live Demo application. Navigate to woodgrovedemo.com. From the right side of the screen, click on Select a Use Case button. From the list of use cases, select the Edit Your Account option. Read the instructions. You can also learn how we configure the Woodgrove tenant. To start the demo, select the Start the Use Case button. On the sign-in page, select the desired sign-in option. If you don't have an account, select the No Account, Create One option. You can also sign in with social accounts like Google or Facebook. I already have an account, so I enter my username and password. After sign-in, you will be taken to the profile page. You can also navigate to the profile page by selecting the profile icon from the header. The profile page shows the user profile attributes alongside with some other options. To edit the profile, Woodgrove requires you to sign in with multi-factor authentication. If you have not signed in with MFA, select the Edit Your Profile button and complete the MFA challenge. You may notice that single sign-on session is still active, therefore you don't need to enter your credentials, only the second factor. You can choose to verify your identity with your phone or email. Enter the verification code you received. After you complete the MFA challenge, you will be redirected back to the profile page. And now you have the option to edit your profile. At the time of the recording of this video, most of the user's attributes can be read, including custom attributes. But only building attributes can be edited. Therefore, the special diet, which is a custom attribute, is read-only. Update your display name. In this example, I enter my family name. Then select Save to update your profile. After the profile has been updated, you have the option to refresh the security token. To do so, wait for a couple of seconds and select the sign-in button. And now the new display name appears in the header. Now that you have a grasp of the self-service profile editing, let me show you some code. The Woodgore application source code is available for you. From the footer, select the source code link. Under the controllers, find the attributes controller. This code uses Microsoft Graph SDK. The Graph Service client acquires an access token to call Microsoft Graph on behalf of the sign-in user. Then it calls the me endpoint get operation to retrieve the sign-in user attributes, specifying the attributes to retrieve, and also expand the custom attributes. Then the code reads the attributes, including the custom attributes. The HTTP POST operation enters the profile update requests. It first gets the middleware web API URL. And then it invokes the middleware instead of calling the Microsoft Graph API. We have chosen this architecture to protect the user's profile. In the diagram, the application has been assigned with Microsoft Graph user.read permission. Therefore, the application can call Graph API to read the user profile but cannot update it. Only the middleware has been granted the Microsoft Graph user.read/write permission, so the application invokes the middleware, passing the security token, which also known as a bearer token. The middleware is registered in the Microsoft Entra External ID directory and a conditional access policy for the multi-factor authentication whenever someone tries to access this resource. The middleware exchanges access token to receive from the application with a new one that fits to call Microsoft Graph with the corresponding permission user.read/write. Finally, the middleware invokes the Graph me endpoint with a new security token. Now let's take a quick look on the middleware web API. From the GitHub repo, go to the home page. Under the related GitHub repositories, select the Woodgore Groceries middleware for Graph. Under the controllers, find the profile controller. It also uses the Graph service client. Then it calls the me endpoint patch operation that updates the user's profile. You might be wondering where the token exchange happens. Looking into the program.cs file, the add Microsoft Graph reads a Graph API section from the configuration file. Since the scope to call Microsoft Graph is different from the one in the access token that the web API received from the application, Microsoft Authentication Library understands that it needs to acquire a new access token for Microsoft Graph. Therefore, it exchanges security token on behalf of the user, and it is available for you through Graph Service Client class.
In this video, we delved into various methods for modifying a user's profile, including customer service support and self-service account management, which involve the application interacting with the Microsoft Graph's me endpoint on the signed-in user's behalf. Additionally, we discussed safeguarding the endpoint's access through a middle-tier web API. For further details on employing MFA for profile updates, please check the link provided in the description below.
It has been a pleasure having you with us today. We appreciate your time and look forward to seeing you again in our upcoming sessions. Goodbye.